हेलो व्यूअर्स, आई एम दीप्ति हंस। माय टुडेज टॉपिक इज अबाउट प्रिज्म। प्रिज्म इज अ ट्रांसपेरेंट मीडियम बाउंडेड बाय प्लेन सरफेसेस। नाउ यू कैन कैलकुलेट योरसेल्फ हाउ मेनी प्लेन सरफेसेस। दिस इज द ट्रायंगुलर प्रिंसिपल सेक्शन ऑफ द प्रिज्म। दिस इज अनदर। नाउ दिस इज द शेप ऑफ द प्रिज्म। नाउ कैलकुलेट योरसेल्फ हाउ मेनी रेक्टेंगुलर सरफेसेस। फर्स्ट इज दिस रेक्टेंगुलर साइड, second is this rectangular side, third at the bottom this rectangular side. Now three rectangular sections and two triangular section give us a prism. So you can say now that prism is a transparent medium bounded by five plane surfaces, out of which two are triangular and three are rectangular surfaces. Today we are going to talk about refraction of light through a prism. For simplicity, we are taking the principal section of the prism, that is the front triangular side. This is the principal section ABC we are considering for simplicity. Now, incident ray. Suppose this PQ is the incident ray which is coming, and this N dash is the normal. Because ray is entering from air, which is rarer medium, to glass, which is a denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. So when it bends towards the normal, it will follow this path. Now this is refracted ray. This is incident ray. This QM is the refracted ray. This is the normal to the surface, AC. Now this ray is coming from denser medium glass to rarer medium air. It is bending away from the normal, but this time again it will bend towards the base of the prism. In both cases, ray will bend towards the base of the prism. Now, if this is the angle of incidence I1, this is the angle of first refraction, this is R1, second surface refraction, which is R2, ray is coming out as emergent ray ML. And this angle is I2. In some books, it is also written as E emergent angle. This emergent ray, refracted ray, incident ray. If this prism is not here, then this ray will go like this. But if we produce this incident ray forward and emergent ray backward, we will get an angle which is known as angle of deviation, which is written as delta. Now at first surface, this is first deviation. Second surface, this is our second deviation. If we consider this triangle, let it be O. If we consider this triangle OQM, then this is our exterior angle. And we all know that exterior angle is the sum of two interior opposite angles. So with this, we get delta is equal to delta 1 plus delta 2. So total deviation is equal to first deviation plus second deviation. Now, if we consider here I1, it is the sum of these two angles. I1 is equal to delta 1 plus R1. Then what is the value of delta 1? It is I1 minus R1. Similarly, delta 2 is equal to I2 minus R2. So our first equation gives value of delta is equal to I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2. It means I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. Let it be our second equation. Now coming to quadrilateral AQN dash M. In this quadrilateral, AQN dash M, this is angle of prism A. Angle of prism, this is A and this is QN dash M. As we know, these two are normals. So angle AQN dash is equal to AMN dash. It means both are equal to 90 degree. So remaining two angles of quadrilateral, their sum is equal to 180 degree. It means this angle QAM plus q n dash m is equal to 180 degree. Now we know QAM is angle of prism, so this is angle A plus q n dash m is equal to 180 degree. It means q n dash m is equal to 180 minus A. This is our third equation. Now coming to last equation, which is in this triangle q n dash m, this is, what is the value of this angle q n dash m? Q n dash m is equal to angle sum property 180 minus r1 plus r2. But from this equation, r1 plus r2 and 180 minus a, both are equal to q n dash m. So these right hand sides are also equal. It means 180 minus a is equal to 180 minus r1 plus r2. 180 is same on both sides. So it means r1 plus r2 is equal to a. Now r1 plus r2 is equal to a. So our this equation delta is equal to i1 plus i2 minus a. So this will give us the main relation between all the angles, which is a plus delta is equal to I1 plus I2, or we can say a plus delta is equal to I1 plus E. So overall relation is angle of prism plus angle of deviation is equal to angle of incidence plus angle of emergence. This is the relation between all the four angles which are formed in this prism. Now we are going to discuss about factors affecting the angle of deviation. First and most important factor is angle of incidence. To understand the interdependence of these two, we are going to draw I delta curve, angle of incidence on x-axis and angle of deviation on y-axis. Here, when we are going to increase angle of incidence, then angle of deviation first decreases. At a certain minimum value of angle of deviation, this is the minimum value of angle of deviation known as delta minimum. After this, when we are going to increase angle of incidence, this angle of deviation also increases. So interdependence of I delta curve is it initially decreases and then after a certain minimum value it starts increasing. It has been found that this minimum angle of deviation is found only when angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. You can also write I is equal to E. And for equilateral prism, it happens when I becomes E equal to E, then this ray becomes parallel to this ray, this refracted ray. This is incident ray AB. This refracted ray BC becomes parallel to the base of the prism. And this emergent ray makes the same angle with the normal which this incident ray makes. This position of the prism is known as position of minimum deviation, in which angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. Now it has been found that when angle of incidence is equal to 48 degree, then the ray BC becomes parallel to the base of the prism, and at this time angle of emergence is also equal to 48 degree. So from the relation A plus delta is equal to I1 plus I2. Now both I1 and I2 are same, so we can take them as 2I. In equilateral prism, angle A is equal to 60 degree, so 2I minus 60 degree. Now if angle of incidence is equal to 48 degree, then this becomes 96 minus 60, it means 36 degree. So in equilateral prism, angle of deviation is 36 degree, and this is the position of minimum deviation for an equilateral prism, because angle of incidence is 48 degree, angle of prism is 60 degree, angle of emergence is again 48 degree, then angle of deviation is 36 degree. So now the first factor affecting the angle of deviation is angle of incidence, and the relation is delta minimum is equal to 2i minus a. Delta minimum, it means the minimum angle of deviation is equal to 2i minus a. If it is a position of minimum deviation. Now material of the prism means refractive index. So delta is directly proportional to refractive index. If it is given that the angle of deviation is more for flint glass than for crown glass, it means refractive index of flint glass is more than refractive index of crown glass. Third is angle of prism. Again, deviation is directly proportional to angle of prism. If angle of prism increases, then angle of deviation also increases. Last factor is wavelength. The angle of deviation is inversely proportional to wavelength, or you can say it is mu for violet color is more than mu for red color, it means deviation for violet color is more than deviation of red color. Out of the many important questions related with prism, I want to discuss this one question with you. Here, two identical prism A and B are given, and this PQ is our incident ray. Remember, whenever ray enters the prism, it will go towards the base of the prism. So it will go towards the base of the prism. If it is equilateral, then it is parallel. If it is not given that it is equilateral prism, then only towards the base of the prism. Now, when it comes out from denser to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. It means again towards the base of the prism. When it strikes this surface of second prism B, then it enters the prism and again tries to bend towards the base of the prism. And when it emerges out from the prism, suppose it is M, N, then you will notice that this PQ is parallel to MN. PQ ray is parallel to MN because it is given that these two prisms are identical. So this PQ incident ray and emergent ray are parallel to each other. Let us understand this question with the help of laser light through this optical box. Now you can see rectilinear propagation of light. It means light is traveling in a straight line. When this straight ray of monochromatic light strikes the first surface of the prism, you can see it is coming out from the second reflecting surface of the prism and it is bending towards the base of the prism. This is the property of the refraction of light through a prism. Whenever it passes through a prism, it tries to bend towards the base of the prism. Here I have placed two identical prism inside the optical box. You can see when laser light strike on the first refracting surface of the prism, it is bending towards the base of the prism, and when it strikes the second refracting surface of the prism, it is coming out from the second refracting prism and the ray is parallel to the incident ray. This emergent ray of second prism is parallel to the incident ray of the first prism because it is again bending towards the base of the prism. You can see two parallel rays very clearly inside the optical box. Here you can see rectilinear propagation of light means straight monochromatic ray of light. When it comes and strikes the rectangular glass slab, you can see incident ray, refracted ray inside the slab, and then emergent ray which is coming out from the slab. Incident ray and emergent ray both are parallel to each other. But of course there is lateral displacement. In my previous video, which is regarding the refraction of light through a rectangular glass block, I got a query from your side is, which is refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium is given as the relation given by the relation speed of light in medium 1 divided by speed of light in medium 2. It means V1 upon V2. Now, in mathematics, this is the rule that we can multiply and divide any fraction with the same number. Here, I am dividing and multiply with C. So, we can also write V1 upon C multiply by C upon V2. Or, I can write it as C upon V2 divided by C upon V1. Now, C upon V2 is the speed of light in air divided by second medium. It means this is the refractive index of second medium. And in the denominator, this is the refractive index of the first medium. So, always remember that whenever we have to calculate the refractive index of second medium with respect to the first medium, whenever speed is given, then formula is V1 upon V2. But whenever refractive index is given, it is calculated by the formula mu 2 upon mu 1. Hope you have understood the refraction of light through a prism with the help of ray diagram as well as optical box. Happy to see your queries again. Thank you for watching my video. We will meet next week. Thank you.